Ship here, and today I'm gonna give you a very nice warm-up exercise for the right hand, and with it you will also master the five pentatonics position. If you don't know them yet, click on the link below, you'll have the full five gauge position of the minor pentatonic scale. This exercise is for warming up the right hand and for getting a good knowing of where the strings are. So what I'll do, I'll play a simple G minor pentatonic. Position one. So that's all you need to know for your left hand. G minor position one, I hope everyone knows it already. So what I'll do, I'll play a note from the minor pentatonic. I'll play it two times, and then I'll play the open G string two times. Something like this. And then I'll go to the next note. The next string. When I go to the G string, I play note and then open, then, and I also, when I go to the D string, I have this consonants. It's not very consonant, but okay. I may be a little bit out of tune, but that's not the point here. Once again, I'll play it a little bit faster so you'll get some sense with this exercise. Sound like this. Little blue note. Then you go up. Then you can go to position two. Do it. Okay, what you need to look after, because at the beginning you will do this exercise while watching the right hand. So as you know, most of the time a guitarist is watching his left hand, not his right hand. But at the first times you do this, you need to watch your right hand. My approach is that you need to have the same pick angle to all the strings. So when I do, I use my pinky to pivot, to move down and up. I don't hold it still and do this. I'm not doing. So as you can see, when I reach the lower strings, my pick is in a different angle than it was here. So that means, if you do that, that means you must get your hand to get used to play each string with a different angle, and I don't think this is very efficient. There are guitarists who do that, but I don't think, I don't prefer that. So as you can see, my right hand, I'm always in the same angle. So I'll do it once again, slowly. Sorry. So your first level is with G minor pentatonic and with D minor pentatonic, as you have there are in the middle. If you try, if you get more advanced and you want your string skipping to be harder, you can try, for instance, B minor pentatonic. You have the B open string, and we have here position 4. Exercise would be like if you want to get harder, you can try something that goes well with E. For instance, we can try E minor. Of course, we have position 2 of E minor here. And you do this. This is very good for riffing. Do it like slower. To have more fun with it, you can try play, for instance, like E major pentatonic. That means you have to play C sharp minor. So that's my C sharp position 4, and if I play it with E in the bass, it will sound like I'm so happy. Know your left hand and watch the right hand. When you first do this exercise, you have to watch your right hand. After you get comfortable with it and your left hand already knows its position and stuff, you will stop looking at your right hand. First, you look at it like. Always try to be on the right string with the right angle. You can use your pinky to pivot. You can. There may be some of you that don't hold the hand on the guitar. As you can watch my elbow and my right hand, you can see that I'm moving like that. I'm moving kind of from the shoulder movement I have, like this. I'm just like I'm not doing this. So. But it's a very, very, very short movement. I mean, imagine you have to move like how the distance that is between the strings, you have to cover it a little bit like this. So that's it. That's one of the best exercise for the right hand, because it will get your string skipping ability, and you also learn pentatonics, and it also sound nice. I mean, I love the exercise that sound nice and that you can use in a musical context. And this string skipping thing you can use in a lot of flyups. You can also use it in like having like a pedal note. So I have this E note here, and I do. So there are many uses of this exercise and of this technique, and it also helps you warm up your right hand and be able to play like really fast stuff. When I played metal long time ago, I had some RSI because I didn't do warm up of the right hand. I was playing like some Pantera songs and some Metallica songs, where it's always a lot of downstroke, only downstrokes at fast tempo, and without warm up you get tensed and it's not good, and you're not be able to play guitar for a long time. So don't get injured. Warm up, take it slowly at the beginning, and you'll get there fast enough, hopefully. Don't forget to subscribe. See you. Bye.